in here with Donnie Simpson.
Yeah, yeah.
This is really awesome. This is
Mike, right. I'm dancing.
This is monumental.
Yeah, dancing.
Look, yeah. Two steps.
I got in trouble when I stand up and dance.
That's all you got. Move your shoulder.
Well,
right.
Well,
you move.
You were getting it in the chair.
Get it now. Get it. We are back with Donnie Simpson, also known as Dr. Green Eyes.
Yes.
We wanted to keep him. I know. I'm saying. Don't do
it. Does that embarrass you?
No, I don't care. But I've never, ever once said Dr. Green Eyes.
We did.
The Green Eyed Bandit. Or anything. You get all these bandit monikers. And I'm like, I don't know where it comes from. But it's cool.
I'm from the Green Eyes.
Right. Well, you are here, and you're a legend, and you're with us, and you have green eyes. How about that?
Yes. All right. And they're fabulous.
I know,
right.
They really are.
Thank you.
So I do want to talk a little bit about old media versus new media. I do have a podcast. Podcasts are very big. Satellite radio is huge. Is that changing radio the way we've seen radio, the way we've loved radio?
Yeah, well, I think a lot of things have changed radio, the way we've seen it and loved it. You know, podcast is just one of the many things that mm-hmm. is affecting it. I'm starting my own podcast.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, a whole network, DSPN, like ESPN?
Yes.
The Donnie Simpson Podcast
content?
Network.
Oh, yeah. I've got a great podcast.
Right. Absolutely. Absolutely. So I'm excited about that because, you know, that's the future.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I need to move into that as
absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely.
But, you know, there's so many things that have impacted it, radio and the way we hear it now, you know, from all the conglomerates buying up all the radio
mm-hmm.
stations
yes.
and you're getting a corporate sound where, you know, I'm sure you remember when I would fly and I'd land in Houston or New Orleans or LA, couldn't wait to turn on the radio.
Yes.
Yeah.
To hear the sound of that city because
yes.
they were all different.
Yeah.
Right? That's all homogenized. It's
yep.
all the same. I can listen to any station in 2 minutes and say, oh, that's smooth jazz. That's
yeah.
right.
You know,
mm-hmm.
and I hate that.
Yes.
I loved all the flavors that
of
it
radio.
Was before.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, you know, there have been a lot of things that have impacted the change of money. I mean,
yeah.
money has dried up.
Yeah.
You know, it's gone to the internet. A lot of those
yeah.
advertising
mm-hmm.
dollars.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, so it's different. But for me, I'm blessed that it's still the same.
Yes.
You know, I'm able to do what I do. I play what I want to play,
mm-hmm.
you know, which is just unheard of these days. And it's not that I'm proud of that. I'm happy that I have it, but it makes me sad
yes.
that
yes.
others don't, because there's so many young people out there with great ears that never get to express themselves.
Yes,
wow.
yes, yes, yes,
you know?
Yes.
And to me, you would be amazed at what you will get from talent if you let them go.
Yes.
You know, instead of trying to control it. You know, let my people go. Come
yes.
on, man.
Yes.
Yes.
Seriously.
Well, Danny, I got to ask you, you've interviewed so many phenomenal people. I mean, music moguls. Mm. I mean, people who have done some fantabulous things in music. What's been your most memorable Ooh. Interview? And who was that person?
Wow.
Or people.
There's
yeah,
so
people.
Many.
Yes, I mean.
There's so many.
Yeah.
I remember having Barry White on
nice.
Video Soul one day.
Yeah. I thought, I saw that episode.
Yeah. So we were, so.
It's my age.
We had finished our interview. So we're sitting there. Some young group had come on. And, you know, they had a hit record. And the girls are throwing their panties.
No, not the panties.
You know, so they smell them. You know, they're like, they're really high on themselves. You know,
right.
come in with all this attitude. Barry leans over to me. He says, how long you give him, Donnie? And I said, 6 months. He said, you can almost mark it on the calendar, can't you?
Wow.
Like that.
Wow.
It was so deep, but it was deep because to this day, I have no idea who that group was. I
yes.
mean, it was
in and out.
Wow.
In and out.
But that attitude, I remember Smokey talking about it at the BET Awards, how you can't, you know, don't get caught. I don't think you invented this.
Right.
Yes.
I know
yes.
that's
the
right.
first to do this.
Yes.
You know, and you have to be humble. Keep yourself humble.
Yeah.
You know, because if you don't humble yourself, he will.
Come
yes.
on now.
And believe me, you'd yeah. rather do it than have
man.
Him do it.
Yep. Man, oh man, oh man.
Yeah.
And speaking of God humbling people, Donnie, we have to ask. I mean, well, not like that, but we have to ask. Being so privileged to have someone that's been in the industry for so long and has seen so many entertainers, male entertainers,
mm-hmm.
What is your thought process when it comes to Mute R. Kelly and all of the male...
Time's up.
Yeah, Time's Up and
yeah.
you know, Harry Weinstein.
Harvey
Weinstein.
And now Morgan Freeman.
And now Morgan Freeman and Bill Cosby, for Christ's sakes. Like, what is your take on this? And have you seen this before this era?
No, I've never seen anything like this. I mean, this is pretty amazing to me. And that's not to say that I'm naive in thinking that it didn't happen.
Yes.
I just didn't see it. You know, I think a lot of that stuff was swept under the rug, like so many things were in the past. But, you know, I think it's tragic, you know, to see what Harvey Weinstein's going to jail.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And Bill Cosby, you know, he's going to jail, too. You know, R. Kelly is just so brilliant.
Yeah.
His music was just... I mean, just some of the most amazing music. And it's a shame that now you feel like you have to mute this because of all of these allegations against him, these things that he's done to these young women.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Bill Cosby, the day that Bill was indicted, I remember that morning I was rejoicing. I was, because I felt like you can't tell me 50 women got together to tell the same lie.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
You know, and to drug them. Right. And he said he did it himself in the deposition.
In the papers, yeah.
You know, so... So I was happy and rejoicing, and then that day when I saw him walk into jail, I started crying.
Yeah,
that's how everybody. It's like mixed emotions.
Because he meant so much to us.
Yes.
You know.
Yes.
So it's tough, you know. But you got to answer for this stuff.
Yes.
You know, you can't go around mistreating women like this. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's just it's ridiculous. Mm-hmm.
Donnie. On a lighter note,
yes.
In 2015, you were indicted.
Lord
have mercy, Jesus.
I didn't know she was 13.
The wife is right over there.
No, listen. In 2015, you were inducted in the R&B Music Hall of Fame, right?
Yes.
So you are the only non-musician to ever be inducted into this situation. And there was a particular quote that I want to make sure I read and get this right. This is so special to me because I'm not cool enough to be in a group of musicians. But it says that what I did impacted them significantly, and that's really cool. What exactly do you think impacted? What was the impact that it's been when you were inducted?
Well, you know, I mean, every day of my life, I have artists come up to me and talk about what it meant to sit on that couch.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that it, you know, I remember going to see Boys to Men one night in Los Angeles. So before the concert, I went backstage and they, man, tell them the date. What's the date? They all knew, and this is group members asking other group members, they knew the day they were on video.
So, wow.
And this is some 10 years later. It was that significant to them. So, you know, so that's very cool to me to have had that kind of impact. And, you know, when I say I wasn't cool enough, it's like, to me, musicians have always been the coolest people in the room.
Yes.
And I said this in my induction speech that night, that my evidence was Prince at last year's Oscars.
Ooh.
Here you are with the biggest celebrities in the world. Movie stars make 40, 50 million a year. Prince walked on that stage, they were like, oh!
Right.
They were like little 10-year-old girls.
Right.
Wow.
You
know,
they're always the coolest people in the room, and for one night, they let me in their group.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow.
That was cool to me.
Yes.
That's awesome.
Today, you might be the coolest person.
Right.
Yes. Donnie, thank you so much. It has been our absolute pleasure to have you. Thank you.
By the way, I have a book coming out.
Oh, yes.
So,
yes.
Yeah, just real quick, it's going to be my biography. This is the first time I've mentioned it. I wanted to do it.
Yes, exclusive.
Yeah, yes. It's an exclusive.
There needs to be a movie made about you.
Yes, absolutely.
That's next.
That's for sure.
We're going to get Denzel to play me.
Yes!
I love it.
So I'm excited about that. So I'd love to, you know, I'll let y'all know when it comes out.
Okay,
hopefully late this year.
We'd love to have you come back and talk about it.
Yeah,
awesome. Thanks for having me.
Well, coming up later, well, first of all, let's give it up for Donnie Simpson.
Yay!